everyone, it's Jordan Robertson with Benzinga, and joining me today is Michael Gareau, Chairman of the Board, Founding President, and CEO at Starpax Biopharma.
Nice to be here.
How would you define Starpax Biopharma, and what makes it different from others in the health tech industry?
Starpax is a company that has developed a new modality of cancer treatment. We have conceived a therapeutic complex that we inject directly into the tumor, and also conceive a medical device for the treatment. And one cannot work without the other one. But something that really differentiates Starpax from others is that we are not just an ordinary pharma or biopharma or even biotech. I would say Starpax is a kind of biopharmatech, because at Starpax, we have four distinctive scientific research departments: biochemistry, microbiology, electromagnetic engineering, artificial intelligence, and it took all these four scientific disciplines to create our unique cancer treatment. That is very unusual in the industry.
Can you tell us a little about Starpax's Magneto-drones and PolarTrak?
Magneto-drones are Starpax living bacteria that we have developed in our laboratory, on which we attach the drug to their surface. First, they can swim in the interstitial space of the tumor tissue without needing blood vessel. Second, they are injected directly into the tumor. Third, they are sensitive to very, very specific magnetic field created by the Starpax PolarTrak. Fourth, they are aerotactic, meaning they search for low oxygen areas that we call hypoxic zone. This is where cancer stem cells are located. And fifth, they die within 1 hour after injection. Concerning the PolarTrak, it is a medical device that we have invented in which the patient is installed. It generates virtual monopole magnetic field to control the trajectory of the magnetodrone in three dimensions. I mean, turn right, turn left, go up and go down. So the PolarTrak creates a magnetic sphere around the tumor to trap the magnetodrone inside the tumor so that they don't escape in the patient's body. At the same time, PolarTrak forces the magnetodrone to distribute with precision throughout the whole volume of the tumor, including hypoxic zone, while they release the anti-cancer drug on their path.
Can you tell us about the founder's personal history with the company?
I have been in high-tech as a serial entrepreneur for 42 years. I was the founding president of Hypax Capital. It was a successful company, ranked in the top 10 private equity firms out of 20,500 PE firms in the world. And as in many families, cancer has been devastating for my family. My father died from cancer the same day at my graduation at university. Also, two of my brothers died recently from cancer. My third brother had the prostate removed, and today my sister is treated for three cancers. So I know what it is to suffer from cancer and from the terrible side effects caused by the treatment. Then I discovered in 2016 two patents about virtual monopole magnetic field. And I was so amazed by this technology that I decided to quit my own PE firm to acquire these two patents for myself to create this unique technology for cancer treatment. I incorporated Starpax 6 years ago. Since we have built a GMP manufacturing plant for the magnetodrone, three laboratories, and our PolarTrak is already installed at the hospital for clinical trial. Now our technology is protected by 50 patents and pending, and we expect to start clinical trial in the spring 2024.
How do you see Starpax Biopharma solution fitting into the current market?
As I said, the Starpax technology is conceived to solve a major resistance problem that has not been addressed by existing treatments. Our technology aims to address all solid tumors that represent 90% of the market and 89% of cancer deaths. According to the industry expert, this is a $900 billion annual market within 6 years. Usually, a pharma or a biotech gets an FDA approval for one drug, and it is for a very rare cancer that represents a small fraction of the market. But the Starpax magnetodrones are conceived to deliver across the whole volume of the tumor many approved drugs for many types of cancer. That means Starpax could reach a cancer market up to 35 times larger than companies that have only one approved drug for a rare cancer. It is enormous, and it doesn't stop there. Starpax intends to develop its platform for other types of disease caused by known cancer hypoxic zone, like ischemic heart disease, pulmonary hypertension, diabetic retinopathy, and acute ischemic stroke. That's huge and very, very promising.
Has the company conducted any trials, and if yes, what were the results?
We have done many preclinical trials on animals, like mice, porks, dogs, and monkeys. In our main preclinical trial, we have outgrown one of the most aggressive human tumor in animals, which is the HTC-116. This is a tumor that doubles in size every 2 days. The trial demonstrated exceptional results. 100% remission rate, meaning it worked all the time, and no meaningful side effect observed. The calculation, according to our protocol on human, has shown 50 times more drug in the tumor and 800 times fewer toxic molecules in the body compared to traditional chemotherapy. So it is extremely promising for the trials in humans. We expect to start the clinical trial in humans around spring 24, which is quite close. We will treat 6 different cancers in the same trials: pancreas, prostate, head and neck, breast recurrence, colorectal, and vulva.
What's a key takeaway investors should know about your company?
The first thing an investor should consider in investment in therapeutics is the risk. According to statistics from the FDA, 97% of clinical trial with new drug fail. That means if you invest in a new cancer drug, whatever it is, chemo, antibody, precision target drug, immunotherapy, you have 97% of chance to lose your money. The advantage with Starpax is we don't develop new drugs. We use already FDA-approved drugs that have been used in humans for years. The mechanism of action of these drugs for humans have been proven, and they are well known by the FDA. Then the risk of fail is immensely reduced. Another advantage of investing in Starpax is the anti-dilution protection of the percentage of shares each investor owns in Starpax. I don't think you have seen this anywhere. That means every time an investor subscribes a new share, Starpax cancels one of my shares at no cost, and the money stays in Starpax. Then the number of shares in Starpax stays the same. As an example, the first person who invested in Starpax years ago still has the same percentage of share he had in the beginning. Another fact-limiting risk is the PolarTrak. Its magnetic field on the patient are the equivalent of those of 6 cell phones. So we don't have to worry about that. Finally, think about the potential market of Starpax when you compare valuation. Our addressable market is nearly 35 times bigger than any new cancer drugs approved these days. And add to that the market for non-cancer disease that our platform could address. That means Starpax can be a major player in the industry.
Thanks so much, Michael. That's all I have for today, and I'll see you next time.
Thank you so much. Have a nice day.